Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to explain the difference between broad, phrase, exact, and negative match keywords. Using keyword match types in Google Ads lets you control when your ads appear as people are searching. Okay, let's start with broad match, which is how keywords are added to the ad groups in your search campaigns by default. This match type provides the greatest coverage or reach for the keywords you are bidding on. As the name suggests, it is going to broadly match the keywords to what people are searching for on Google. So if we were bidding on tennis shoes, our ads could appear as people search for shoes for tennis, buy tennis shoes on sale, tennis shoe, red tennis shoes, comfortable tennis sneakers, tennis rackets and training shoes, and can you wear running shoes for tennis? All of these search queries broadly relate to the keyword tennis shoes. So this is the default match type in Google Ads. The next match type is phrase match. This is where we put the keywords we're bidding on inside quote marks. This tells Google Ads that we want those words to be included in what someone is searching for, or that someone should be searching for something with the same meaning. For example, tennis shoes in quotes can match shoes for tennis, buy tennis shoes on sale, tennis shoe, red tennis shoes, and comfortable tennis sneakers. Phrase match is more targeted than broad match. This means our keyword will not match tennis rackets and training shoes, or can you wear running shoes for tennis, because they don't have the same meaning as the phrase match keyword. Then there is exact match. This is where we place our keyword inside square brackets. This will match the keyword as closely as possible. So tennis shoes in square brackets will match tennis shoe, shoes for tennis, tennis shoes, and other searches with the same meaning. But it will not match buy tennis shoes on sale, red tennis shoes, or comfortable tennis sneakers, as they don't have the same meaning. When we use exact match, phrase match, and broad keywords, it's important to understand that these will also match close variants as we've seen. This will mean Google Ads will automatically match singular and plural versions of our keywords, misspellings, and other close variations of keywords. So remember, close variants will apply to your exact match, phrase, and broad keywords. Here we can see the relationship between each of the keyword match types. For the greatest reach and broadest targeting, use broad match keywords. For narrow and controlled targeting, use exact match. And for targeting that balances between the two, use phrase match. This brings us to our final keyword match type, negative match. Adding negative keywords is an important part of optimizing the performance of your campaigns. Let's take a look. A negative keyword prevents your ads from being displayed, which allows you to reduce the number of less relevant impressions. Here we can see we've added the negative keyword of cheap along with the broad match keyword of tennis shoes. This means that people searching for cheap tennis shoes and tennis shoes cheap won't see our ads. You will notice that our ads are still eligible to appear when someone searches for cheapest tennis shoe. If you don't want your ads to show for cheap and cheapest, you will have to add both of these as negative keywords in Google Ads. This is because negative keywords don't work in the same way as broad match keywords. You need to be specific with negative keywords. Now let's talk about when to use the different keyword match types in your search campaigns. The first thing I want to touch on is that you should start with a match type that aligns with the objectives and budget you've defined for your campaign. For example, if your objective is to gain as much visibility and drive as many people to your website as possible, then you should consider using broad match keywords. As we've seen, broad match will give you the greatest coverage and reach for your ads because your ads will be displayed for a range of related terms. On the other hand, if your objective is to drive as many conversions as possible and you have a limited or small budget, then starting with exact match keywords will mean you're more focused with your targeting. Your ads won't be displayed as often, but you will also have more control over when they're seen as people are searching. So overall, you should consider your objectives and budget when deciding which match types to use. And you can always change this. For example, you might start with exact match and then move to phrase match as you start seeing conversions coming through for your campaign. The next thing I want to talk about is adding the same keyword with different match types. Adding the same keyword using all of the different match types won't provide any benefit. For example, if you add a keyword using broad, phrase, and exact match in the same ad group, this won't improve your results. It just means you're duplicating the keyword unnecessarily. One of the main reasons you might want to duplicate a keyword with different match types is if you want to adjust your bids based on the performance. For example, let's say you have a broad match keyword and you discover that the exact match version of the keyword results in lots of conversions and is really profitable. In this case, you might choose to add the particular term as an exact match keyword and increase the bid. This means you're prioritizing the keyword based on its performance. And just to flag, this technique is only useful if you're manually managing bids for your keywords. If you're using an automated bidding strategy, then Google Ads automatically adjusts bids for you. So using multiple match types for the same keyword won't let you modify bids. Remember that exact match will give you the most control, while broad match will give you the greatest reach. If you're just getting started and you have a small advertising budget, then consider using exact match or phrase match keywords. This will ensure you don't spend your budget too quickly. You can then move to phrase match or broad match if you need greater reach for your ads. And try testing different match types to see what works for your campaigns. Google Ads isn't one size fits all, so spend time in your account to see what works for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.